Hi folks, in this video, we'll talk about what is thermal radiation, how to model thermal radiation heat transfer between surfaces in Ansys Mechanical, and some important tips and pointers related to radiation modeling. Let's go. Thermal radiation is a form of heat transfer in which there's no need for a medium between the two bodies. The energy is transferred in the form of electromagnetic waves that travel at the speed of light. A classic example for thermal radiation is transfer of solar energy from sun to earth and other planets. The sunlight travels through millions of miles of vacuum and yet deliver heat energy. When thermal radiation is incident on a surface, depending on the properties of the surface, some energy is absorbed, some energy is reflected, and in case of transparent and translucent surfaces, some energy is transmitted through it. In addition to this, any surface whose absolute temperature is more than 0 kelvins emits thermal radiation. Depending on how much energy is entering and leaving the surface, it may be gaining or losing energy. The property of surface that defines how much energy is emitted by a surface is emissivity, which is defined as the ratio of the energy emitted by a surface to the energy emitted by a black body at the same temperature. Therefore, it has a value between 0 and 1. In Ansys Mechanical, we assume the surfaces to be gray diffuse, meaning emissivity is equal to absorptivity and emissivity plus reflectivity is equals to 1. In other words, the energy absorbed is equal to energy incident minus the energy reflected, and the net outgoing energy is equal to energy emitted minus energy absorbed. When we calculate the energy transferred between two surfaces, we use Stefan Boltzmann Law, which states that the heat transferred between two surfaces depends on the area of the emitting surface, the emissivity of the surface, absolute temperature of the two surfaces, and the angle of orientation between the two surfaces. It is captured in the form of this equation. Here, AI represents the area of the emitting surface, epsilon I is the emissivity of the emitting surface, and Fij is called the form factor or view factor. The form factor is calculated based on the orientation between the two surfaces. Therefore, it quantifies how well the two surfaces see each other. Sigma is called Stefan Boltzmann constant. Ti and Tj are the absolute temperatures of the emitting and incident surfaces respectively. As you can see, the radiation heat transfer has a fourth order relation with absolute temperature, which makes it a nonlinear analysis. In Ansys Mechanical, we model radiation between two surfaces using the Radiosity Solver, which calculates the form factors between the two surfaces and uses the temperature from the finite element solution to perform radiation calculations. A radiation object is created for each surface that participates in radiation. The user should create only one radiation object for each surface. As part of this object, the user needs to define three quantities: the emissivity, the enclosure number, which is used to identify a set of surfaces that may radiate to each other, or in other words, form an enclosure, and enclosure type, which can either be perfect or open. In case of a perfect enclosure type, the surfaces form a watertight enclosure, and therefore, this option must be set only when the radiation is defined on all surfaces that form such an enclosure. In this case, the view factors should sum to 1. If the surfaces do not form a closed enclosure, then we set this to open and define ambient temperature, so the surfaces lose some energy to the environment. In this case, the view factors do not sum up to 1. With that, let's proceed to the demonstration in Ansys Mechanical. In the demo, we'll perform heat transfer analysis on this steel capsule. It's open to ambient air, and inside there's a concentric steel cylinder that has two copper coils. The copper coils act as a source of heat input to the system. And we assume there's vacuum inside the capsule, and therefore, the only mode of heat transfer between this cylinder coil system to the capsule is via radiation. Note that all the surfaces inside this capsule participate in radiation heat exchange, and they form one enclosure. So, they all share the same enclosure definition. The objective is to study the temperature distribution in the capsule at a steady state. So, let's set it up in Ansys Mechanical. We'll start from Mechanical. The geometry is already imported and the materials are predefined, so let's go ahead and assign the materials. But before we do that, let's create a section view so we can view and access the parts that are inside the capsule. One easy way to do this is to insert the cross-section plane using the XY plane of a coordinate system. The global coordinate system has its XY plane bisecting the assembly. So let's use this. Right-click and insert a cross-section plane. Now that we are able to access all the parts, let's go ahead and assign materials. The capsule and the cylinder have default steel material assignment. Select the two copper coils and set their material assignments to copper. Before we proceed to defining loads and boundary conditions, let's stop by connections. Notice that there are no connections defined between the steel cylinder and the copper coils, which are in contact. But we have used shared topology in the geometry, so they end up having a conformal mesh. Therefore, they share nodes and do not need contacts to enable conduction. Now, let's define loads and boundary conditions. Select all the outer faces of the capsule and define a convection object. We assume the heat transfer coefficient to be 1E minus 5 watt per millimeter squared degree centigrade, which is close to the heat transfer coefficient of stagnant air at ambient temperature of 22 degrees centigrade. Next, let's define the thermal load. Define internal heat generation object on the two copper coil bodies and set the value to 5E minus 2 watt per millimeter cube. Next, let's define radiation boundary conditions, starting with the capsule. Select all the inner faces of the capsule and define a radiation boundary condition. Change the correlation to surface to surface. Set the value of emissivity equal to 0.8. Change the enclosure type to perfect and make note of the enclosure. Rename it to radiation capsule so it's easier to identify it in the model tree. Next, let's define radiation on the steel cylinder. Select all the exposed faces. Notice that the cylindrical surface is split into three parts due to shear topology. This is important because if this was not the case, then the portions that are overlapping with copper coils would be included, and this will result in incorrect view factor calculations. It's important to exclude overlapping surfaces that are not visible in reality, as they don't participate in radiation. Go ahead and change their correlation to surface and enclosure type to perfect. We'll use emissivity of 0.9 and make sure that the enclosure value is same as the other radiation objects. Rename it to radiation cylinder. Finally, define another radiation object and scope it to surfaces of the coil. Set the correlation to surface and enclosure type to perfect. We'll use emissivity of 0.2 and make sure that the enclosure number is same as the other radiation objects. Rename it to radiation coils. This completes the setup. Before we solve, let's define some result objects too. Right-click on solution and insert a temperature object and scope it to the outer capsule. Next, we'll insert the thermal probes to radiation boundary conditions. To do this, select the three radiation boundary conditions, drag and drop them on solution so the probes are created. Right-click on them, rename based on definition so they're easier to identify in the model tree. Now, let's go ahead and solve the model. Looking at the temperature distribution inside the capsule, we can see that the capsule is heating up due to radiation. Now let's look at the radiation probes, starting with the probe on capsule. The radiation probes report four values. The outgoing net radiation, which shows how much net energy is entering or leaving the system due to radiation. A positive value indicates loss of energy, while a negative value indicates a gain of energy. In this case, the capsule is gaining energy and therefore heating up, as witnessed in the temperature distribution plot. The net outgoing energy is calculated as difference between emitted and absorbed energies, as discussed earlier. We can see similar results reported in the other two probes too. Next, in order to verify that the radiation heat exchange is being accounted for properly, let's verify the view factor calculations. Go to solution information and review the solver output. Scroll down to find the view factor smoothing table. This table is available only for the enclosure types that are set to perfect. In this case, these four values should be equal to ensure that a watertight enclosure is used. In addition, the errors reported should be very small. A rule of thumb is that they should be in the order of magnitude 1E-4 or less. A larger value of this error indicates incorrect model definition. For instance, in this model, say we haven't used shear topology or imprints between the steel cylinder and the coils and include the overlapping surfaces in the radiation definition. Then here's the resultant view factor smoothing table. You can see that these values are not identical and the errors are much larger, which implies that the definition of radiation was incorrect. This may result in either incorrect results or non-converged solutions. This concludes the demo. Now, let's summarize a few important points. Radiation is a mode of heat transfer where there's no need for a medium between the bodies. It is governed by Stefan Boltzmann Law, which is fourth order relation between heat transfer and absolute temperatures of the surfaces. Therefore, it's a nonlinear analysis. Ansys Mechanical uses the Radiosity Solver to calculate the radiation heat exchange between two surfaces. In case of perfect enclosures, the summation of U factors equals 1, while in open type enclosures, it will be less than 1. This concludes the video. Thank you for watching. If you found this useful, please like and share the video and subscribe to this channel. Also, please visit ansys.com/courses to discover more useful content.